Kobuk, but a late freeze of the Kobuk River has so far prevented the family from cashing in.
If you don't do things right, you're gonna end up dying. If we don't know how to check the ice and we don't know what the thickness is and the dangers are, we could get killed. If you don't do it correctly, you just get removed from the gene pool. Even if we have to wait an extra day, instead of running just a 50-foot net and getting a potential of 10 or 20 fish for ourselves, we're trying to run at least 100-150-foot net, and we're gonna try and get enough fish that we're secure, that we'll be able to trade fish all winter. So it's gonna be more than just a personal fishery. It's gonna have a lot to do with being able to trade. It's gonna have a lot to be able to do with giving away, and it's gonna have a lot to do with us eating.
But it looked like 4 inches.
This stuff's okay, but over here is worse. Thinner, thinner, thinner. I'm going all the way through, Agnes. 2 inches ice.
Whoa, fuck that.
Oh, fuck. Same deal. The snow cover that we had here didn't allow this ice to thicken so well. See, it's just water. The thing is that it just gets thinner as we head out towards the center of the river. This is thin ice, Agnes.
Fuck that. I don't really like going on the ice, but it's something I have to do. And it's been 21 years and 3 weeks since my mother went out fishing her last time. We ran 2 nets. We had one here and we had one further up. And me, my dad, and my younger sister, we were just like 5 miles away from each other. And they were on their way back from the fishing hole. And this old man, he comes cruise along the edge and he's like, some people fell through the ice and I don't know who it is. And then I was like, what the hell? And then I thought for a minute and I turned around and I went back up to the house and I say, where's my mom? Where's my brother? Did they get back yet? And he's like, no, they never come back. They're still out fishing. And right there, I fucking knew it. And my brother was right under my mom. And we never did find my brother's girlfriend. My mom taught me to be tough. My mom taught me to be strong. Try not to show my fear to my younger girls, but I caution them and I tell them to always know the safety in their surrounding areas where they're working at and always be safe, because even though you think it's safe and you go over it yesterday and the day before and the day before, it's still not safe. So it's just a scary fucking thing. I don't fuck around when it comes to ice. Yesterday we didn't even go out this far. We were just along the edge.
It's safe to walk on. It's not safe to take a lot of weight. If we're gonna have several people here, we're gonna have a net that weighs several hundred pounds, and we're gonna bring out several hundred pounds of fish along with the net, all into the same place where we're all working together, this is gonna be a disaster. So we're not gonna put a net in. Nothing we wanna do today, that's for sure. Sometimes this is what nature does to you. Sometimes these things happen, you don't get a choice, you just roll with it. I think we're just gonna have to wait and hope that the good weather comes back. It's just kinda like going to the store and not being able to find lettuce when you really crave a salad. Ice fishing this year just isn't a happening deal. Ooh. Water!